Did you start ordering out for dinner more often during the pandemic? Most of us did. How do you know the food is clean, untouched, and safe when it finally gets to you? As it turns out, there are no national food delivery standards. The FDA is working on that now. It's hosting a virtual summit with leaders in the food delivery industry to come up with some guidelines. Here's NBC's investigative and consumer correspondent, Vicky Nguyen.
Hello. Chinese?
Greek food.
Hamburgers. Thank you so much.
Whether it was a hankering for sushi at midnight or maybe pancakes for dinner, food delivery services made it even easier to get whatever you want delivered right to your doorstep. And Americans, well, we dug in. Food delivery services made more than $26 billion last year. But just who's watching to make sure this gets safely from the restaurant to your door?
Complaints involving food delivery from restaurants to meal kits to groceries are skyrocketing, says Patrick Quaid, founder of IWasPoisoned.com. It's a website where people can report food poisoning to help identify outbreaks in real time.
We're seeing an explosion in the number of reports.
Quaid says delivery complaints have increased tenfold since 2017.
We both had nausea, vomiting, and other stomach issues.
I was actually, in and out of the restroom. So it was not a fun time for me.
The main culprits behind the illnesses, Quaid says, food sitting out too long before or during delivery, and meals that aren't packaged in tightly sealed, tamper-proof containers. Check out this viral video, a driver in Miami sipping a woman's drink. One survey found one in four drivers admitted to eating customer food. Now the FDA is stepping in, meeting for the first time to figure out how to make delivery safer. After all, 91 million Americans downloaded food delivery apps just last year.
There's more food being delivered to homes today than ever before, and we need to make sure that we're keeping pace.
Frank Yannis oversees food safety at the FDA. He says of particular concern, food ordered online and through apps. Right now, there are no national safety standards.
Would you characterize it as a Wild West? It's up to different companies to figure out how to safely transport the food.
Yeah, I don't know that I characterize it as a Wild West. The reality is these new models are emerging pretty rapidly. What we want to do is we want to make sure that we define one best way of doing it.
We reached out to some popular apps. All had their own safety protocols, including using hot bags to maintain food temperature, tamper-resistant packaging, and telling drivers to keep cars clean. Still, it's a patchwork of rules set by different companies and local and state guidelines.
Say you get a meal kit delivered to your home. What's the first thing you want to do?
Well, the first thing I'm going to do is when I order it, I'm going to hope to try to have it delivered when I'm home. I'm going to look at the package and see that the package is intact, see if there's any leaks.
Always check the temperature. Hot food should be at least 140 degrees. Cold food and raw meats, 40 degrees or lower.
Fancy trick you can use is actually place the dial stem in between the packages.
Oh, that's a cool hack.
When ordering a restaurant meal,
I want that food delivered as quickly as possible.
Ideally, within an hour max, but that doesn't always happen. We ran into a wrinkle with one of our orders. The restaurant called to let us know it was ready, but it was 90 minutes before our scheduled delivery time.
We asked them to remake the order so it'd be fresh, but I don't think there's any way we can tell whether they did.
To protect yourself, order from restaurants you know or those with positive reviews. Opt for those that give real-time tracking of your order. Be home to receive the items and check for sealed packaging. Actions you can take to ensure your food is safe.
Hey, Shep, grocery delivery was also extremely popular during the pandemic. I don't know if you've ever done it, but we placed our first orders during the last 18 months. That is also going to fall under this effort by the FDA to set some federal guidelines. And we should remind your viewers that, look, if you get sick and you suspect it came from your food delivery, your grocery, or maybe your meal kit, report it to the company, ask for a refund, and consider calling your local health department to report it as well. You could save someone else from getting sick.